Previously on Dream Team.
80 million to spend, and owners who don't want to interfere. What am I going to argue about?
Does my deal still stand? But I did what was asked. How am I supposed to...
Cheating is wrong. The man's breaking vows, and the mistress, she's betraying another woman.
I'm so sorry, Sam. I didn't mean to hurt you.
I would leave her, but she would never let me see my children again.
And that's why you slept with Amy Kerrigan behind my back and made a pass at Linda Block.
Just call the police!
Chester hanging on in this FA Cup third round tie against Championship side Crewe. It's Kenny Lunt, and how Felix Hahn needs that full-time whistle. It ought not to have been a struggle, but Harchester's poor form has turned it into one. In by Lunt, danger here, and Alex O'Meara with a save, and somehow it stayed out. My goodness me, we almost had a replay at Gresty Road. Eugene Rose still out of favour. What does he have to do to get back into this side? We're into the last seconds, and there is the full-time whistle. Harchester have won, but only just by a goal to nil. They've arrested that slump of four defeats in five games at the end of 2005, but they need to up their game significantly with Manchester United coming up in the semi-final of the Carling Cup.
Solid performance, mate. Fans would have strung us up if we'd lost that one.
Well, something's got to be done.
The ball just keeps coming back. We can't do that against United.
Don't even go there.
Well done.
Jesus, talk about paving over the cracks.
No, yeah.
The United game's one game. Clubs to be injured for.
What kind of talk is this? What would they think if they hurt you?
Gaffer, I was joking.
Sometimes a victory can be all you need to turn things around. We must set the example to the players.
Guys! Linda would like to see you all in the players' lounge. Quick as you can, please. This came for you.
Thank you, Amy.
I'll see you upstairs.
Would you?
I'm a married man.
Never stopped you having an opinion.
There's our answer.
What, Eugene?
No way.
I've tried talking to him. He won't have it.
Semi-finals against Man United have a way of clearing the mind.
OK, listen up, everyone. Now, although that was a damn good win today, I don't need to tell you that recent form has been unacceptable. Now, I want you to use this new year as a new leaf. A chance to put events of 2005 well and truly behind us. It's been 6 years since our FA Cup victory. 6 years! That's just not good enough. We're not some small club, happy with survival. Now, we're two games from Cardiff. And yes, Man United is a daunting task. But with the help of Felix and his two wonderful coaching staff, we're going to have you fully prepared. Giving him your all on Wednesday night. All of you. Do I make myself clear? Okay, thank you.
Where did this come from?
What do you think?
When did they deliver it?
Must have been about an hour before the game.
Do you know what's in here?
Felix, I hope you didn't mind me doing that down there. It's just that I think the sooner we get back to Cardiff, the better, you know? Might help people exercise a few demons, and with any luck, put a smile on the face of the fans again, which I'm desperate for. Anyway, I know some managers don't like it when the suits get involved, so...
Linda, as always, I value your input.
Oh.
In my office.
Felix, I've got work to do.
In my office, now.
Talk. They want me to resign now?
If that's what it says in the letter.
I didn't think it would be right before a semi-final. At the end of a season, maybe. Do they realize how bad this is going to make me look?
Walking out now.
When would you like to make the announcement?
When do I get my money?
They told me it would be transferred into your account as soon as you read the letter. Shall I arrange a press conference? What will you do?
I don't know.
Eugene, I'll expect you for training tomorrow.
Expect what you like.
For some reason, Felix feels you deserve a place against United.
Not feeling it.
I'm sorry, lads. What about the team? You're just going to sit there and watch them struggle, without you? You've got a job to do. You know, most people are killed to be in the position that you're in, and all you can do is...
Look, you don't know nothing about me. What are you doing?
Why won't you play?
Look, the game just brings me grief, all right?
But you'll still collect the money, though, right?
I'm on compassionate leave, remember?
You faked the whole thing. I could have died. Your brother nearly did, remember? Hey! You'd be in prison right now if we hadn't kept quiet. You can't even play a game of football.
Look, if it makes any difference, I'm probably going to prison anyway. I'll take the stairs.
Are we going to get on with this, or what?
Of course, this is completely off the record. But say, if I was to become available, you've shown some interest in me in the past.
I don't know, maybe he's buying a player.
Yeah, a striker who can be here by Wednesday.
Surname isn't Rose.
Amen to that.
My situation in Harchester. Let's just say I have some loose ends to tie up. Yes.
Eugene hasn't turned up. Again.
Alex is going to be taking the session.
And what about United?
Are you expecting to play Eugene? What are we going to do about him?
What's our formation going to be?
I'm sure Alex can work that out for himself.
Are we going to play with one up or two?
All right, lads, let's get going, eh? Come on.
Come on.
Week for Felix Hahn, who'll be teaching his players the three R's. That's Ruud, Rooney and Ronaldo. Dragons fans everywhere will be praying the German tactician can outwit Sir Alex Ferguson, just as he did when his PSV side knocked United out of the Champions League.
Something to
Hey.
Hey. So what do I owe this honour?
I'm here to take you home.
Why?
It's my job. And you saved my life.
Did I? Sorry, it's all a bit of a blur now. So go on.
One of the gunmen fired a shot, and you...
Was it sort of just a random shot, or was it headed anywhere in particular?
It was headed straight for me.
And then what happened? I mean, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt your story.
And then you dived across me.
Oh.
You took the bullet.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm amazing.
Yeah. Okay.
I want to ask you about Eugene. It's just, since you and he talked, we need him. Is there anything you can suggest that might help? Is that out of order?
Running a little low on favours, maybe. We just agreed we weren't going to hate each other anymore.
Here's your departure itinerary. I was told to bring it to you.
What?
Tells you exactly what to say at the press conference, explains why you're resigning, what time you're flying out, arriving, everything else.
Easy does it.
Ash, look, as much as I appreciate you picking me up, I'm fine.
Felix. Press will be told you're having problems with your family and you're going back to Germany to sort them out. You wish you could have seen the job through and you want nothing but the best for the team.
Why am I leaving in semi-final week? Does it say that?
No. I guess just things have got so bad at home.
You guess? This is my reputation. Managers don't walk out on their players because of an argument with their wife. What time do I leave?
9 o'clock Wednesday evening from East Midlands Airport. Here's your letter of resignation. All you have to do is sign it. You could do it now if you like.
I need to speak to Linda first. I can't just walk out without explaining.
You are not to communicate with Linda Block.
But I brought her back to the club.
Felix, I really need you to sign that letter.
No. Do you see £3 million in there?
It probably just takes some time to clear.
I'm going nowhere until I get my money.
Why are you stalling? It's not as if there's anything keeping you here, is there?
I'm glad you asked me to come over.
Please.
There's stuff we really need to talk about.
I agree. You first.
Casper wasn't willing to help with Eugene. Understandable, but it was worth a try. Personally, I think we should cut our losses. Work with the lads who really want to play for the club.
This isn't why I wanted to meet you. I want to talk about us. I'm sorry I brought Catherine over here. I only did it because of the thought of you and that boy. It was a mistake. I made you think the opposite of what I wanted.
Which was?
You thought I didn't want you.
You showed me that everything you told me was a lie.
Why?
You told me that your relationship with her was over. It was just for the children.
It is over.
I know you're lying.
Don't tell me. She told you she was pregnant, and when she found out about you, she had an abortion. That's not true. I swear to you, I haven't slept with her in years.
Then why would she say such a thing?
She uses the same line every time I...
Sleep with someone else.
That's not what I meant, Ashley. Please. You are the only one.
Save it for Amy. Oh, why now? Why just before our most important game?
I just need to know if there's still a chance for us.
Thank you.
Welcome to the Dragon's Lair, which has enjoyed some wonderful nights of cup football, and this has all the ingredients to get the pulses racing again. It's Carling Cup semi-final first leg, Harchester against Manchester United. Sir Alex Ferguson has seen the Champions League go out of the window. No sign of the big names being rested for this one. Some mind games too from Felix Hahn. His lineup has been shrouded in secrecy up until the last minute.
Why aren't you downstairs?
I'm coming. Just a couple of things.
Right. Oh, we should really speak to the owners about money.
What?
Who we can afford. We've got 3 weeks left of the transfer window. And if we get into the final, it should give us a bit more to play with. You feeling confident? About tonight?
Yes, of course.
Good. Well, good luck then.
Eugene! Eugene, open this door! Eugene!
Did I hear someone knock?
A letter from Linda Block, stating that your compassionate leave is over. It also stipulates that failure to turn up when selected for a squad, you'll be sued in breach of contract. Fancy another court case?
Look, you don't understand. I'm not doing this to mess you up. I will not be no use to you.
We only need you for a sub. The formation doesn't include you. Most likely you won't even play. We need the cover. Please.
A sub. Wait there.
It's in.
Then why are you still here?
I just need to say my goodbyes, then that's it.
It's a packed house at the Dragon's Lair, a cracking atmosphere. The kickoff just minutes away.
Really need that team sheet, Felix.
There you are.
Well, I've got him here, so what do we do?
You've got to start
him. Hey, watch that. I only agreed to come if I was a sub. I'll be straight out that door again.
Felix, speak to him. You can make him play.
Come on, guys, time's up.
Together, you know.
Ashley, please, I need to talk to you.
For God's sake, man, get in there and give a bloody team talk.
When I came to this club, I really believed we could do something special. I still believe it. I'm sorry I haven't been there for you these last few days. But I know I've left you in great hands. Whatever happens tonight, stick together. Alex?
I've never heard you give a team talk like that before. What, is that reverse psychology or... Are you okay?
I never should have let the job get in the way.
What are you saying?
It was always you.
Going to watch from the stands.
This is the place to be, and what a welcome for the Harchester United players for this semi-final first leg of the Carling Cup. Sir Alex Ferguson has seen it all before with United, but it's hostile, it's intimidating, and this is the Harchester lineup. No Casper Rose, but Eugene is back on the substitutes bench. Maybe a lone striking role for Gavin Moody. Tim Howard is preferred to Van der Sar in the United goal, and Saha partners Rooney in attack. It looks as though Felix Hahn won't be taking up his usual place on the Harchester bench. And it's going to be a nervy night for this young Harchester side. How will they shape up against this strong Manchester United lineup? And it's they who will kick us off.
Come on, Harchester!
Early ball will seek out Ryan Giggs. He's been in and out of the United side this season. He's coming forward with some menace here, and that is a foul. There's no question there was a bit of contact there from Ryan Naismith. And a useful position here for Manchester United. Fortune is going to tap it here for Scholes. And Naismith and Carter charged it down well. But it's broken now for Gary Neville. And the first shot in anger from United. Time really Harchester have got deep into Manchester United territory, but they're defending fairly comfortably with Gary Neville, and now it's Ronaldo. He's a key figure for Harchester to keep quiet tonight.
Don't stand off him.
He's getting a little bit too much room here. Harchester can ill afford to
let him know you are there.
Your car's here,
and now it's with Ryan Giggs. Maybe two cross, plenty in the area as well, including Ronaldo!
Here are your plane tickets. You should make it in plenty of time.
First class?
Of course. You need the legroom.
Well, goodbye, Amy.
He's gone.
Harchester finding a bit of possession now. Carlisle for Ryan Martin. They haven't put an attack together of any significance yet, though, Harchester. Forward by Rossi, and that's offside against Gavin Moody, and they are missing Casper Rose badly.
How are we doing?
Awful. Have you seen Felix? Where the hell is he?
Harchester's struggling to find any sort of rhythm. They need some leadership, and they're hardly getting it from the bench. Still no sign of Felix Hahn. Alex O'Meara has been the difference at the moment. By far the busier of the two goalkeepers. Manchester United dominant, but it stays at 0-0.
Felix.
Hi, it's Ashley King here at Harchester. Can you tell me, have you sent any cabs here in the last hour or so? Where to? East Midlands. Sorry, via where? Barons.
Harchester have been unable to ask any questions at all of Manchester United defensively throughout this first half. It's Rio Ferdinand. Amazingly, though, we're still at 0-0 at the Dragon's Lair. Here's Giggs out to Gary Neville. Well, Giggs has made a smart run forward here, and he's got away and scores. Well, you had to say that goal has been coming, and you also have to say that is quite magnificently taken by Ryan Giggs, getting on the end of Gary Neville's superb through ball. And it was all about the composure of Ryan Giggs at the end. His manager will be absolutely delighted with that, and why not? As for Felix Hahn, what will he make of it? Conspicuous by his absence.
Read your letter. I suppose you were going to do me the courtesy.
I tried to tell you, but I couldn't.
After everything. Have you got another job?
No.
So where are you going?
Back to Germany.
To your wife?
No.
All that rubbish you told me about rebuilding the team, working together, I bought it.
I meant every word.
Yeah? So much so you're walking out the team just when they need you most.
I'm not walking out.
Well, what is it you're doing whilst your team is out there being humiliated by Man United?
There's things about this place you don't know.
I'm all ears.
The owners of the club, they offered me a lot of money, a deal I couldn't refuse. But there were certain things I had to do.
Such as?
Sign the Rose Brothers.
What? All that crap about watching them playing together. Everything we've been through. The burglary?
No, I swear, listen to me. I did see them play as children. The dream of the Rose Brothers was my dream.
Then why are you walking out on them now, just when there's a chance they might actually play together?
Part of the agreement was that I'd leave when I was told. I thought it would be 1 or 2 years, but...
So that's it? You're just going?
The plan was to go together. We could do whatever we wanted.
How much? Come on, how much are they paying you to walk out on the team mid-season? That's not the man I fell in love with. The man I love wouldn't betray the...
Set.
Still, Harchester nil, Manchester United.
Can you turn it up, please?
But amazing in a match of this importance. Inexplicable, really, that the inexperienced Alex Dempsey, the first team coach, should be put into this position. He's doing his best.
Sounds like you're best off out of it.
Harchester are lacking leadership.
Take me through the club. Manchester. Take me through the club, and quickly.
He come forward in search of a second. It's breaking now for Paul Scholes. And Harchester have to keep it out until half-time. Ryan Martin's header away, and there is the half-time whistle. Well, that is a half that the Harchester players will want to forget in a hurry.
We might as well drive him to the cup final ourselves the way we're playing. Where the hell is it?
He says carry on without him.
What's going on?
Just do the talk, Alex.
Lads! We all know that if we play like that in the second half, we can forget about Cardiff.
The worst half of the season! And we are only 1-0 down. It's nothing. 1 second. Bang! Goal! And we are level. Guys, 3 halves of football to go. They think this game is over, but they just hit us with everything. We haven't even started. Okay? Becky, you're off. Not your fault, changing formation. Eugene, you're on.
I ain't playing.
Everyone out!
Gaffer, we still got 10 minutes to go half time.
On the pitch now!
Come on, boys, let's do this. The gaffer says, come on, let's go! Let's get up for this thing.
Well, I agree. It is almost unprecedented. The Harchester players have only been in the dressing room for 5 minutes, but the manager sent them out already.
Come on, then. Give it all that about how I'm supposed to be so lucky to be playing football. Do you want to know where it's got me? A dead mother, a broken marriage, abuse all day from man on street. If every kid wants what I got, then they can just step right up and take it.
It's not about you. It's about this.
All right, all right.
Harchester United still trailing by a goal to nil, a goal scored by Ryan Giggs. Here's Oja for his skipper, it's Danny Sullivan. Comfortably dealt with by Gary Neville. Oh, and finally we get to see Felix Hahn for the first time today. Well, whatever his vantage point was for the first half, he doesn't look happy with what he's seen. And strange to see Eugene Rose emerging late from the dressing room, stripped and ready for action alongside his coach. But it needs a change, and Ojo will come off for Eugene Rose.
Oh, thank goodness. Our manager's decided to turn up.
Ryan Naismith, Gavin Moody, they tried to work the 1-2, but safely pouched by Howard.
Yes, I know. I've seen him. I don't know. Look. I'll take care of it, okay? Of course. I won't let you down. I promise.
Rossi. Movement much better from Harchester now. Finally, Felix Hahn gets to play a leading role against Sir Alex Ferguson. In by Giggs. Alex O'Meara at the second attempt. Danny Sullivan! Now, Eugene Rose, can he make the difference? He's done well, got the space, it's Danny Sullivan! Oh, you beauty! It's all square at the Dragon's Lair, and the captain, Danny Sullivan, makes it 1-1. What a difference!
You got the call as well?
Oh, yeah.
Need to get back out and see the game.
Thank you all for coming.
What's going on?
Well, I thought I'd give you the chance to get the big exclusive.
What have you got?
Well, if you don't want me to tell you, that's fine.
No, go on then.
Well, if I were you, I'd press Felix Hahn on his future at the club.
No chance, he's only just arrived.
Well, then why is his letter of resignation sitting on Linda Block's desk as we speak?
Jody Carter for Eugene Rose. His presence in the second half has visibly lifted this Harchester United performance. Still 1-1, semi-final first leg of the Carling Cup. Felix Hahn has had so much from his players in the second half, but he wants more. It's Damien Evans. Gavin Moody in support, looked like a foul on Evans, and it's given. There's consternation and uncertainty on that Manchester United bench. Harchester need a win to take to the second leg at Old Trafford. Not long left. It's Carter's ball in. Oh, and it's gone all the way in. Harchester lead 2-1. An element of luck. Tell that young man about it. He'll tell you he meant it. Jody Carter just shy of the full-time whistle. And Harchester United, unbridled joy all around the Dragon's Lair. Somehow it got beyond Tim Howard and the United defenders, and it's going to be surely a first leg lead in the Carling Cup semi-final for Harchester. Referee has the whistle to his mouth and it's all over. What a finale, and what a turnaround in the second half. The presence of Felix Hahn did make a big, big difference, and the coach takes all the plaudits here. Harchester win by 2-1, all to play for in the second leg.
Come on, what did you say to Eugene at halftime?
Look about earlier.
Shut up.
I am ready for love. Why are you hiding from me? I'd quickly give my freedom to be held.
You're not there yet, you know.
Good win, though, eh?
Big win. Thank you.
Mrs. Block needs Eugene and Felix for the press conference. Soon as possible, please. Felix, you've made yourself a hero. Time is up. I'm warning you. Tell the world now. Just go.
It's just so good to see the fans enjoying themselves like that.
Eugene, is that your best performance in a Harchester shirt?
Probably my best ever, to be honest. It's been a while since I enjoyed playing football like that.
What did the manager say to you at half-time?
Well, he slapped me about a bit, hotted me, and, you know, I thought I'd better play well, otherwise he might bang me up proper after the game.
Felix, where were you in the first half?
I was watching on a monitor inside.
Why is that?
Because I wanted to.
What's your reaction to rumours tonight that you've handed in your resignation? Is this your last game in charge of Harchester United?
No. I love it here. The staff, the players, we have a great time together. I want to bring success to the club. And if somebody wants me to go, they're going to have to make me.
Linda, I'm still on duty.
Oh, don't be silly, you deserve it.
You have no idea what you've done.
Let them do their worst.
Felix.
Hey, at least the sponsors were in a good mood tonight for dinner.
I'm sorry, Linda. I won't be able to make it.
What? It's been the diary for weeks.
Tonight I have a prior engagement.
I don't care. I'm getting divorced. You're a singer. Why should people not know we are together?
But what about work? We always say that.
They'd have to know something. I mean, what if we got married? Had children?
What? Where's all this coming from?
Ich liebe dich. I love you. Not here. We are going to pick up your things. No more living out of a suitcase. I want you to come home with me.
Are you asking me to move in with you? Are you asking me to move in with you?
Will you prepare Miss King's bill, please? She's checking out.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure. I should have done it months ago. Welcome to the rest of your life.
Baby, that's the corniest thing anyone's ever said to me.
Wow.
not this corny.
Just take me away.
That looks like a new look.
I don't understand.
Ash? You break it in? It's a bit more Eugene style.
Felix got locked out. I'm sorry about the noise.
I see.
Wish me luck.
I think he needs your help.
Yeah. Can't you turn that thing off?
2656, nothing.
Maybe you changed the code and forgot.
The code is always the same, my birthday. The police will be here any moment and the damn thing will not stop.
Hey, calm down. Look, these things happen. Have you got the number of the security company?
How can they change the code of my house without telling me? And then refuse to give me a new one.
It must be something the club has done. Some kind of mix-up. Look, we'll sort it out in the morning.
A room double one night.
I'm afraid it's been rejected.
Try it again.
I have, Mr. Hahn. Do you have another card?
It's a business expense. I don't want to use my personal cards.
It's okay. I'll get it. I can have my old room if it's still available.
Certainly, Miss King. Thank you.
I know what this is.
What?
It's them. Arset make me. They are making me.
Who's they?
Wait here, I'll be back.
Stop! Stop! They're stealing my car! You just stand there, why didn't you make him stop?
He said he was repossessing it. Here.
Das gibt's doch nicht! Call me a taxi!
Where's Amy Carrigan?
Felix, I don't know, I think Amy's gone home already. But we're all in the middle of a meal, so are you free to...
I need to see her, I know she's here.
More champagne, anyone?
Yes, I've done it. I've got his passport number here. It's 801.
You've done this to me! I won't be forced out of the club!
Felix, I tried to warn you. You don't know who we're dealing with. I don't want to be doing this, I swear.
Don't give me that! Give him back my life!
Let go of me!
Please, if you think about... What the hell was that? Excuse me.
Oh, you're hurting me!
Shut up!
Going on?
Coming up on Dream Team.
This is a big thing to accuse someone of. Felix could lose his job.
So what? Supposed to tell the press I lied?
Maybe you misunderstood.
You're suspending me.
I just think it's for the best.
If you don't believe me, no one will.
I didn't do it.
Then why didn't you tell me?
Because I knew you would react like this.
Because you could cover it up.
I was ready to go that night. But now, it's impossible. I have to stay and clear my name.
We have to stop them.